He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, let's practice our nuclear reactions. An alpha particle reacts with magnesium 25 to produce a proton and another nuclide. What is that other nuclide? So if you're not sure how to approach this, go ahead and check out my tutorial on nuclear reactions, and when you're ready, give it a try. Okay, so let's write out the reaction that is represented here. We know that we are dealing with magnesium 25. So we're going to start with Mg, and that has an atomic number of 12, as any magnesium atom will. And so we put a 12 down there. And then this particular nuclide has a mass number of 25. So we can put 25 on the top left. Now we know that that is going to react with an alpha particle. So what is an alpha particle? We have to know that an alpha particle is a helium nucleus. So we can write helium, we can write He, and we know that any helium nucleus is going to have two protons, so we need a two there. And then specifically, an alpha particle is two protons and two neutrons, so that will have a mass number of four, so we can put a four on the top left. Now we said that we are going to produce a proton. And what is a proton but a hydrogen nucleus? We know that every hydrogen atom will have one proton in its nucleus. So we can write H for hydrogen. And since there is one proton in the nucleus, that's an atomic number of one, we're going to put a one on the bottom left. And since it's just one proton, it's just one atomic mass unit. So we have a mass number of one, and we can put a one on the top left as well. And then lastly, we have another nuclide. We don't know what the nuclide is yet, so we can just represent that as X. And we don't know either of these values, so let's just put Z and A, and we're going to calculate those now. So the atomic numbers and the mass numbers must be balanced. That means that the sum of the atomic numbers on the left side must equal the sum of the atomic numbers on the right side, and the sum of the mass numbers on the left side must equal the sum of the mass numbers on the right side. So, taking a look at mass number first, on the left we have 25 from magnesium and 4 from helium. So that means that must be equivalent to 1 plus A. Those sums must be equal. So if we do the arithmetic, we get 28 for A. So nuclide X has a mass number of 28. Now let's do the same for atomic number. On the left, we have 12 from magnesium and 2 from helium. So 12 plus 2 must be equal to 1 plus Z. And if we do the arithmetic, Z must equal 13. So if this nuclide has an atomic number of 13, by definition, it must be of aluminum. So we can put an Al there. And that is the nuclide in question. We have aluminum 28.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.